sense, because apparently some of them have complained about, if they show up to, work something, they're not getting paid for that at the time.
Well, here is our pay, and then they're not being paid correctly.
Well, I think they're at the minimum, if I remember correctly, because when I served on that board, but, they're at the minimum per meeting, and I think what they're trying to do, and I'm not saying that I disagree with this, is they're trying to basically add more meetings. Does that make sense? So they're not raising their pay, they're just getting more meetings. I mean, I don't know how to say that in any way. I mean, unless I'm misinterpreting what they're doing.
I understand, but I'm looking at the law right here. I understand what they're trying to do, but I'm not for sure that we, that it's good to operate outside of the law.
I'm not working for that. I'm not. Whenever I talked to Matt, he was saying that some of them had expressed interest in getting paid for certain things that they were doing. They felt like if they put their an hour's worth of time in, then they should get paid for that hour's worth of work. And that's how they justified raising that, unless I'm misinterpreting. Which I don't think I did, because it's basically what it said. Just explaining. But yes, they did jump up to 1,800. And that's in a non-election year, too. Well, we got one election. Got one election, March 3rd, Friday. And this year's late.
They took the request on the election commission meeting by $1,000. From the original. But then again, it went down to line 332. And the increase from 15.
This one, did you say it's $1,000?
$192.
Oh, okay, that's what you're saying.
They took the request by $1,000.
Okay. That's the new one taken today.
And then on the line 332, the increase of $1,500, just for it. And then to get down here, to line 719, and it says the election commission agreed to a cut. But they left, and what was the request? More than $1,000.
$800 on this old page.
It was $15, is it office equipment?
Yeah.
It was $15.
It was $15.
Yes, sir.
So what had happened for, do we just reject it? If we don't agree with salary, administrator would reject it, go back to them, or do we say $66?
It looks like the main one, that as long as we give the maintenance of effort, they're like, kind of like the schools, they can reject it, but that's still what they're doing.
That's it?
Yeah. I mean, that's the way I.
Or is that you're referring back to last year?
Well, let me say this, let me re-qualify that. Maintenance of effort plus the state mandated rate.
So do we want to go through and take their original submission, and then go by line and put in here what is current request, and what was in the original request, and go to that?
Well, if a person were to take the names from them, and that was our option, law option.
I think that's.
You got the question? There is a change to clerical. Go ahead.
The problem is, again, is that we got to, we need to make sure that we're going to abide by the law, everything we do, trying to do the best we can. So I'm not for sure that it would probably be a good idea to send them a letter and let them know that they need to, like the election commission before, that they decide to increase the election commission, that it might be a good idea to read that part of the law. And you know, because I'm sure they probably were not aware of it, and that if that they decided to increase it, it would be done by resolution by the county legislature and approved by the county legislature.
As long as they were making some effort, and you know, we're good.
So what are you saying, you want this office to notify them in writing that this is what they want?
I'm looking at the old budget, this budget, yeah. Are y'all still on that one too?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't understand how on 101 it went from 67,262 to 66,554. So actually, that's that $1,300
insurance.
That's the insurance, okay. And you're saying we're at 2162, went up from 21,315 to this new version of 21,741.
And also, election commission, actually, the original budget was 5,000, now it's at 4. So that's what I'm saying, it's kind of they kind of changed the numbers, so I just didn't know if y'all wanted to come up with new numbers.
Well, see, that would also change social security, maybe, there too.
Yeah,
Jim is right, he's talking about going back to last year's budget. These are actual numbers in the $18,000 money.
Yes, these are actual numbers.
Yeah.
I'm talking about pay scale. You know, I'm talking about going back to the administrator.
Keep bringing up the MOE to do that, you might have to raise it, what?
$2,000.
No, 166, 164, ain't $2,000.
Oh, okay, 166, so.
Well, the big jump in last year's budget to this year's proposal is that it was $1,800 for election commission.
Oh, I know why.
Did it went to
election?
Then they replaced.
That's why I changed.
Of course, that's a change. Then they spent election worker $24,900. This year, they're proposing $14,500. That number's the same. So if you go through the numbers you see.
That 166 would link the names better if they only have one election in that budget. Had two, we would have to go back to that 174. Which we will next year because we'll have the August and the November election. They do odd, every other year they have two elections.
State retirements is also lower because that was the savings for state retirement. Line 204, as far as the numbers from last year, 174. So that's proposed at 1706.
So what would you say the bottom of this table?
Again, Kim needs to keep us between the bottom lines, making sure we are quoting good ones as best we know what we need. I just took the difference between the 66,574 versus the 70,258. This is on their budget. And that's a difference of 3,684. And I just subtracted off of the bottom number, the 172, so it ends up being 168,565, which is actually a little more, as you see, but we have it at 166,544.
So the only change to their proposal, the second proposal, 66,574.
Well, entirely insurance.
Diane, did they get with you on the Social Security and Medicare and those kind of things to recalculate? Did they get with you on they didn't? So the odds are
they're a little bit less than what
you got. Okay, so somebody doesn't calculate the raise above, is what you're saying?
Right, they're a little bit higher.
But the last thing we want to do is keep going up.
about 7:40? Oh, go ahead. I'm looking at numbers.
Is there a reason that the maintenance agreement went from $16,000 to $29,000? Whatever, does anybody know about?
Didn't you say something about that during the last?
I missed it.
Something like there's a.
He actually lowered that home state because he got, this is.
Voting.
She voted.
That's what they.
Yeah.
Because they actually spent $26,674 the last fiscal year. It was a huge increase, but the increase actually hit last year.
Well, I think they're more prepared for this last election, you know, with all the security, same election actors and all that. They can do a lot of things that they don't do there.
I make a motion about the $166,000.
I have a motion on the table for the original budget. I believe that I'm looking at $166,514. Do I have a second?
I got a question. That includes the $5,000, you ever want to do something about that? On 192?
You know, it's just like what we talked about, we give them a certain amount and it's up to them to address it. The thing is that we really need to let them know that that's operating outside of the law. It would be a good idea. They don't, I'm sure that, you know, I just have them read it and go, whoa, wait a minute, you know, because we're working on the budget. So somehow or other, they need to know that if they do raise that up, that it's not, that it needs to come before the county legislative body. I don't know. It's kind of a little mix right here. We've got, I'm not sure.
Well, they get $50 a week to get a chair with this election.
Well, I understand that, but like I said, why don't we just go by law, you know?
I'm not arguing with this.
That's your question. Should it then square away the rules? Why else would change the lay down that?
I'll be honest, I don't think they're raising their pay. I think they're increasing the number of times they need. That's why they've got the $5,000. So technically, I don't believe that there's a legal issue, but that's something that they're increasing.
Well, if you can drop that line, $1,160, now put it back on the back of your office, you should have election issues.
Well, and again, you know, again, like I said, any kind of raise that they're giving themselves, it had to be approved before the county legislative body resolution is what it calls. That's what it calls it.
Per meeting. If they raise the same $50, $75, that's what we're.
Even if we pay them all, you know, we just need to.
I'm gonna read through it again.
Sure.
What is the taste here?
That is, what I'm just saying.
Is it 2-12-208?
That was the.
Yes. Yes.
It's part of that, the same.
Part of the same.
This is what it says.
Yes. That's one TCA.
But I'll read it again. It says a minimum compensation. Of course, this is regurgitated by CTAS, you know, to help us, you know, put it in plain language rather than TCA. But in their plain language, it says a minimum compensation for members of the county election commission is specified by statute and varies according to the population of the county. These amounts may be increased in any county by resolution of the county legislative body. In order to trigger the daily rate, a commissioner must work at least 1 hour in any given 24-hour period. But payment is made for meetings lasting less than 1 hour if they are required by statute, budget preparation, or litigation.
here with, it looks to me like if they didn't have it, so you got, what the workers affect, how much, I understand what you're saying, so you're basically increasing more, having more meetings, increase the amount of money you have to have on the payment, because the multiplier is $50. But the only thing I don't understand is that line 193, they actually drops election workers from $24,000 to $14,500.
Yes, see,
So it's me like you.
That listening.
Yeah, right.
You know, I'm not arguing for them, don't take it that way.
They might have fewer poll workers.
That's true.
But, you know, another, instead of 5,000, bring back 38,400, the 17.
Do that.
And which, that'll drop it to 163,354. If not mad.
Well, if we're gonna do that, we probably need to walk the line completely, like, we know exactly what we're changing. That's my suggestion.
Go ahead.
So the AOE pay stays at what, or drops to what, 66,575? $5,74, excuse me. Clerical personnel, 21,13.
Which I got to, 1,741, and that fact that's.
21,3.
I'm saying you have to.
21,315, yeah, the paper they submitted was 21,741. Just trying to make sure whatever motion gets on the table, what numbers we have to plug in. So.
That's probably a 2% range.
He was 2 or 3, he identified it as.
Oh, 2.5.
It's why it's a small increase.
Yeah.
And I do apologize, I was looking at the old where it was 5,000, I see it's smaller, it's 2.5.
Yeah.
I wonder how much the election workers get paid now.
$120 a day. I'll give you a little bit for that.
That's what.
I know.
That's a lot of rent, but kind of set up.
Almost, right.
Okay.
So, which one's 62? The labor like it is?
21,315. Election commission?
Jim says go down to the 38,400.
38,400.193.
That would be the same one. Because that's how much they need for the total. For what you said last year.
In-service training? Any change? Social security?
That last one, that one.
State retirement. Employee insurance. Medicare. Communication. Legal notices, recorded costs. Maintenance agreement, $29,000. Service repair, $800. Postal charges, $500. They're stopped, they don't change. Printing and stationary forms, $1,500. Travel, $2,000. Custodial supplies, $200. Office supplies, $650. Office equipment, $800. Somebody got that cut? $163,354.
$165.
One 165? What's the last, 165 what?
354.
354.
A little less deep social security, Medicare's retirement, so.
So we have a motion for vote on 165, 354?
I make it.
Jim, I have a second. Well, I wasn't sure, you come up with the first motion.
Well, the 165, 354.
We done the other. 165, 354, what y'all got?
Yeah. So, we're gonna vote on the election commission, 51,500. Jim's got the vote, Jim's got the motion, Kim's got the second, any more discussion concerning election commission? Call her up.
Russell Reed.
No.
Corey Davenport.
Yes.
Karen Ashford.
No.
Jim Bush.
Yes.
Rick Mitchell.
Yeah.
Rick Raymond.
Yes.
Randy Gannon.
No.
Kim Davenport.
Yes.
Ronnie Mahoney.
Yes.
For my math, I have, I think that concludes the county's general fund. What's that?
Norma has hired a new employee, and she's going on the insurance, so we need to add a couple of dollars.
What's that?
Norma hired a new employee, and she's going on the insurance.
Do you know if that position was announced? In the paper, 1,000, 1,000, is anybody there? Does anybody know?
She's off. We also have an employee resigned today, just probation. Put in her notice today, so should be gone by September 11th. Put something out, maybe get the paper. What's that?
What process would go through to get that employee?
Please, Jim, that's true.
I'm clarifying, she works, missing being on probation for her title, and I'm working with Ben Rogers to clarify how to identify her job. But Angie, over here, I hate that she decided to go somewhere else, but a smart officer, a pretty good job.
What's the salary?
The same thing.
That.
Yes, I do. I'll have to go back and go over, she is another type of thing.
This should be something, 42, 43,000.
42.
Smyrna has a private probation, and that one being banned, but just yet. We were in a private lawsuit, it was private, and then they got into a lawsuit, and we got into the, we got away from private, we hired an individual, just, so. It's true, I guess we could go back to the main private contract.
Do what?
Right, she did it by herself.
They have no real now, who seems to be named, in mind. So we hired the legislative body, hired that last time, did we?
I don't know.
Who hired?
Mike.
On the recommendation.
I thought the whole commission.
She was already working, and the whole commission turned that into that full.
Right. Well, that's what the commission turned into a county audit. So I guess we could turn it back out to a private office.
I think we're supposed to be making money on that one.
No, breaking is.
Breaking.
It's hard to break the.
But we did that partly because she was staying late, so that some of these people could come in and see her.
After they get off work.
At work, right.
Because before, they were calling in while they were at work,
they were getting fired because, you know, they'd leave the job earlier, wouldn't come in at all.
I'm wondering, is this something that maybe Judge Melvin will be?
Well, she just, yeah, I already talked to her today about it. She is concerned about just getting somebody back in position, keeping the system going. She, Jessica, like I said, dropped her paperwork to me today, notified me, and then Judge Melvin called. And I wanted to clarify that, something, is a county employee or not, how do you advertise a position? I'm gonna take it back out, put it in a private contract. I'm not sure that you start with smart, she's gonna work smart, I just don't know.
It's a project.
Another word for this, though.
I was also wondering, maybe say that do some counties take, do that out, do those services out of the circuit court clerk's office or something? Does anybody know that?
I don't see any question.
Do some counties run their probation, pay their probation and everything out of their circuit court clerk's office?
Circuit court is, it's a state probation. State.
You mean, you don't say court?
General sessions criminal, you've got the majority of them on, with the county, you have a sizable percentage that is private.
So what's our advantage? $61,000 out of our budget?
Probably that's why they're gonna lawsuit with the private company, charging session fee. I think that's what they got trouble for.
Yes, that's exactly what it was. We were tied with Murfreesboro, that's exactly wrong.
Yeah.
And then they got into that thing, yes.
But it was a bad company that did a bad thing, so they got in trouble. Not all companies are bad.
No.
There's a lot of laws. Can we possibly pursue maybe?
You can look at both avenues, this is where you can say that the change might go, or the private, or have, you know, before they're trying to do it. But, you know, there again, deal, that, you know, as long as they work with these people, and they're trying to do their probation, and, you know.
Is that what it was?
Oh, the other company that we had, you know.
And they were winding up going back to jail, which was forcing us to pay them.
Well, I mean, what it was, I mean, they were losing their job.
Yeah.
Just trying to make their schedule appointments.
I remember that.
And.
Then if they didn't make it, then the judge put them back in jail because they violated their probation.
They started out with really good companies, they changed, several companies bought them out, and they lost control. People were supposed to watch over it, they got out of office. Before we go on and fix that problem, Diane, you said that we need to go back to the county trustee's office and add some employee insurance.
Oh, yeah.
It's currently budgeted at $51,051. I'm on page 16, I'm on 52,400 county trustee's office. I was looking at the insurance line, we've already cleared this budget, and the insurance line was, employee insurance line last year was $28,78, this year it's budgeted for $51,051.
So we need to increase that to what?
Plus.
$51,051 plus.
$48,100.
Plus $4,800?
Mm-hmm.